So he underwent a liver transplant last year, and he developed post-transplant jaundice a week or so after surgery. So I did an ERCP and I placed a 7 French biliary stent. So we are in the ballot. And the catheter, the wire is way above the expected site of the anastomosis. And then you can see that the biliary tree opal in that area is a bit dilated and it's tapering towards the anastomosis, which is right there where the tip of the catheter is. We're using a short wire. So right now I'm advancing a FIT balloon through the scope. And again, I'm keeping my fingers close to the port because it's a bit stiffer balloon, which is a good thing. It usually tends to come in the lower part of the ampulla, so it's just a matter of bringing the ampulla towards me, and I do that by moving my dials of the duodenoscope. Go ahead and put 1 cc of balloon. So I engage the balloon at the level of the ballot. And the reason why I want to do that is because I want to make sure that there's absolutely no contrast that goes up other than the one that we're injecting. So inject proximal. So now I just injected not even a cc, and we have everything that we need in the proximal to now inject distal. By injecting distal, then I'm not overwhelming the biliary tree, and I'm identifying there the anastomosis and the rest of the valve. So now, if I were to try to move the balloon like so, I may be forcing a little too much of the balloon against the valve. The valve is about half the size, if not less, the caliber of the biliary tree above the anastomosis. So what I'll ask is to unlock the balloon. As we unlock the balloon, then I can gradually but persistently pull. So I cover the entire biliary tree without causing any type of trauma. At the same time, I engage the balloon enough on the valve to retrieve any debris or to also estimate the caliber. So go ahead and put 1 cc in. And then I'm just going to demonstrate the advantage of balloon sweep with the unlock position. So the beauty of that is that I accomplished sweeping the duct, identifying the anastomosis without causing any trauma, and preserving the integrity of the balloon and the catheter.